Have you noticed lately that people in your Zoom meetings have changed into potatoes or some other comedy character? Have you noticed your friends, when you get together over Zoom, have something else about them? Well, if so, they're probably using SnapCam filters by Snapchat and integrating that into Zoom. We'll show you how to do it so you can turn those boring meetings into something a bit more funny. The first things you want to do is make sure you've got Zoom installed. This process also works with the web version of the tool. I prefer to use the desktop client. I'm using this on PC, but it's up to you. If you're going to use the web browser, use the web browser. So you're going to install Zoom by going to zoom.us/download. Now here you're going to find loads of different things in their download center. The Zoom client for meetings. This is the PC version I'm talking about, and it'll install a client to your PC. You've got all the different plugins as well, so you can integrate Zoom meetings into Outlook, IBM Notes, and other extensions for browsers as well. And also you can see you can get Zoom on Android and on iOS. Okay, so make sure you've got your client downloaded. Up, you're going to want to get yourself over to snapcamera.snapchat.com. Yes, SnapCamera is part of the Snapchat family and allows you to put these filters over your webcam, over your video feed, which is what we're going to be doing in regards to Zoom. So as you can see, you can put all different embellishments. I've gone for the quintessential potato because I think it's quite funny, but you can certainly choose others, and we'll come on to that a little bit later on in the video. So there's a client you can go and download, and you can see there is the download link for the SnapCamera client. Clicking on that takes you to their download area where you've got a license agreement, which I would encourage you to look at. It gives you the minimum operating specifications for the tool. So the minimum hardware core is an Intel i3 2.5 GHz or an AMD FX 4300 to 2.6 GHz. I'm using an i7. Microsoft LiveCam, and I've got a decent graphics card in there for the gaming. So as I said, have a good look through the camera license agreement, which you should always do before installing software. If you're happy with the license agreement, click I have read the privacy policy, enter your email, select that you're not a robot. Perhaps you are, I don't know, but if you're not, select you're not a robot, and then download the application. That'll download to your PC and go through the wizard as normal to set it up. Now, once you've done that, you may be lucky enough to have it detect your webcam that's on your PC. If not, this is what you have to do. In the top right-hand side, you'll see the little cog wheel. We're all familiar with this. This is settings. Click on that. And here at the top where you see Snap Camera Settings, you can select your video feed. Now I've got quite a few things on there from different avatar creation programs like Animaze, Facerig, and ChromaCam. However, we're after the Microsoft LiveCam. Now this is the camera that I have on my PC. For you it might be different, it might be an inbuilt laptop camera as well. All these things tend to work on those as well if your machine hits the required specification. So, select your computer's main webcam from the download section. Right, once you've done that, brilliant. Click on back. And then you'll be given the option to look through several avatars created by the community. And you can see we've got quite a few avatars here. Or you can go through all the different categories as well and get yourself some additional avatars or effects or filters put onto your effect. Once you've got this working, and again, you can select through all of these to find something, I don't know whether it's comedy. You can see it's changed my face already. Make yourself into French fries from McDonald's. Hey, hey, that's quite good. Or even alien. How much fun can you have with this in class? Now, if you're using this in work, be aware that you may have to contravene your workers' policy. Right, your workers' policy and standards of business conduct in work sometimes prevent you from installing applications such as this onto work PCs. But if you're using it on your own device, then hey, do what you want. So just be wary about that sort of thing. So we're going to go for ourselves as having a burger, and it's a nice new burger. What we're going to do now is we're going to come out of Snap Camera. We're then going to go into the Zoom meeting, and here's my Zoom client. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to set the feed that it reflects my avatar and not my face. So into settings, down to video, make sure your camera is set to the Snap Camera, not Life Cam, right? Snap Camera. And what your colleagues or friends from school or classmates or whatever will see will be on the screen. Once you've set that, all you have to do is effectively return to your meeting. So what I'll do, I'll end this meeting here so we can see. New meeting. There's my meeting, into full screen. And there you are, you have changed yourself into a beef burger or into a potato. Now, if you're not happy with that particular avatar, you can zip over to SnapCam, picture in picture, and dynamically change the feed. There you are, and that's reflected in my Zoom meeting as well. I am now a hand. Or I can be an Egyptian statue, which I think is really good. It's one of the best ones I've seen, to be honest. Or alternatively, you can become a piece of watermelon. All this is perfectly up to you, but it does inject a little bit of humour and comedy into your meetings. If you're using it for work, make sure you're there for like-minded individuals, and make sure you're not contravening your standards of business conduct and what you can install on your PCs. If you're using it for school, again, make sure your teacher's cool with that. Can be a little bit disruptive, but hey, we're all about fun and throwing caution to the wind. Thanks for watching. Hope you have fun with SnapCam and Zoom to make those meetings a little less boring. See you soon.